My name is Keith Earl. I'm a professor of physics at the University at Albany. A few years ago, I went to a performance of the Ellen Sinopoli Dance Company, and it occurred to me there were some aspects of what they were doing that reminded me of how electromagnetic fields behaved. So I went up to Ellen after the concert, and we discussed this.
And he was interested in how one might use movement to help students of physics.
In my teaching, I'm often trying to demonstrate fairly abstract concepts. What is an electric field or what is a magnetic field is very difficult for many students. I can write down equations to do the job, but there are some students for whom just having the equations alone isn't enough, but it's often very helpful to have a concrete image that they can work with.
We are currently here at UAlbany doing a very exciting project called choreophysics.
We're trying to take abstract concepts from the realm of physics and come up with a way to represent them through the medium of dance.
We'd sit down in rehearsal and we would talk about these laws of physics.
If you found the correct solution to a physics problem, there is a kind of aesthetic beauty to it. And in working with Ellen and the dancers, I've come to appreciate that creating a performance is very similar.
Something that we've also discovered as dancers is that some very exciting movement has come from a very different way of exploring.
It's often supposed that there's a tension between the scientific project and artistic projects. There is a good deal of overlap in both cases, both in the sciences and the performing arts. It comes down to solving specific problems. Where that overlap occurs, I think, is precisely in those places where creativity is important.